Hey guys, welcome back. Now, torrents really are one of the most efficient methods of downloading any content online. And I don't just necessarily mean, you know, potentially, you know, copyrighted or illegal content, even, you know, Linux distributions, large files, just so many companies are turning to torrents just as a very efficient way of, you know, sharing content with their users. And at the same time, we do obviously know that you can also find things like, you know, movies and TV shows, which could be potentially deemed illegal depending on where you are. So I guess the purpose of this video is firstly to explain exactly, you know, what torrents are, how do torrents work, and then also to answer some of the questions like, you know, will you definitely get a letter from your ISP if you were to download, you know, a movie, for example? And spoiler alert, I can tell you straight away, the answer is no. Just because you download a movie from torrents doesn't necessarily mean you'll definitely get a letter. It all depends on what you're downloading, whereabouts you are in the world, and most importantly, do the copyright holders for that particular content actually care if somebody is downloading, or more specifically, sharing out that content? And that's really the key thing. So in this video today, let me answer all of those questions and also show you a real life example of when I downloaded a movie from torrents without using a VPN, and I did actually get an email from my ISP. So let's jump right into it. Okay, so right from the top, what are torrents? What is BitTorrent? How does it all work? So BitTorrent itself is a communication protocol used for peer-to-peer file sharing. It was invented back in 2001 from a programmer called Bram Cohen from the University of Buffalo. Very smart guy. So he invented this as a real efficient, optimized way of sharing large files. So instead of having a single source server where everybody's trying to get to that server, everybody's trying to pull from a single server, users or people that want to download that file can join what's called a swarm, and in that swarm they can all download and upload at the same time. So even if I've got 5% of a file, I can now share out 5% of that file. So it just means that instead of having a single source, you now have multiple people all in that swarm, all uploading and downloading at the same time. So it really takes out the kind of central single point of failure from the equation, because everybody can join in, even if you have limited bandwidth, we can all contribute, everyone is sharing. It just makes it so much more efficient. And companies, I mean, big companies like, you know, gaming companies, you know, most of the Linux distributions, they come down as torrents just because it's so much more efficient to have people share out the file for you than, you know, the companies themselves standing up individual servers and telling people, you know, connect to this server and download the file, because for that it'll cost them more money. The servers that they put up will have to have lots of bandwidth. It's just not that efficient. So if you only have people that want to download it, then as they're downloading, they can also be sharing at the same time. So it just gives it more of a community kind of feel when you're getting these files. Now, obviously, I'm talking about downloading legitimate files. I'm not talking about downloading anything, you know, illegal or, you know, copyright. And that's where the bad sort of image that torrents has got, because a lot of people do use it to download, you know, copyrighted content, movies, you know, games, that kind of stuff. But torrents themselves are not legal at all, and they're used by, you know, many companies, and even more and more companies are now switching to them just because of how efficient they are. So let's just demonstrate this in real life. So we have a person here who wants to download something. He goes to a public tracker, he finds a torrent that he wants, he clicks on download, and that downloads a torrent file onto his device. You can get what's called a magnet link as well, but for now, for this demonstration, let's just say you downloaded a file, a torrent file, which is understood by your BitTorrent client. Now that file tells you how to join a tracker. Now in the tracker, you'll have other people who are a part of that swarm, who are all sharing that file, or who are all downloading that file at the same time. Now, even if they haven't got 100% of the file, they can now start sharing that file with you. And as you start getting some of that file, you can also start sharing that file out. So this is where the whole peer-to-peer sort of, you know, terminology and concept comes from. So you're downloading and you're also uploading. And that's one of the big issues where when you are downloading something that's, you know, copyright or copyright infringed, is the fact that it's not the fact that you're just downloading this illegal content, you're also uploading it. And that's where the trouble sort of begins. Okay, then, so how are you tracked when you're downloading this torrent? Is it really your ISP that does it? Is it somebody else? Well, in reality, and in my experience, your ISPs don't really care, because this is not their content. So if you were to download a potentially copyright infringing, like, let's say, movie, for example, you know, why does your ISP care? Because it's not their content. Now, the people that do care are those copyright holders. So they own the copyrights to this movie, for example, and they will pay these companies or third parties to basically stop people getting access to their copyrighted content. And the way they do that, so as previously mentioned in my last video or the clip I just showed you, that, you know, so if I want to download this potentially illegal movie, I would join up, you know, a public tracker, I'll download a torrent file that will tell my client where to go off and find the swarm of other people sharing this file. So if I can do it, they can do it as well. So all they need to do is basically just download the same torrent into their torrent client. The torrent client will show you, these are all the IPs that are currently sharing out this file. These are the IPs that are currently downloading it. They can then find the owners of the IP address, which ISPs have this IP. So if we use me as an example, they can say, oh, look, this IP address over here is downloading this torrent. This IP address belongs to this ISP. Let's now contact the ISP and say, you got an IP address here downloading our copyrighted content, tell them to delete it immediately. And that's exactly what happens. But obviously it's not a case of a manual guy sitting and, you know, looking at IP addresses. It's all automated now. So they literally have scripts or bots that go off and join these, you know, swarms. They can see all the IP addresses downloading them, and via automation they, you know, pull the IPs, they find out the owners of those IP addresses, as in which ISPs, and those letters go out automatically. So that made it very slick and, you know, automated, but that's how it works. So how to stay anonymous? So you basically need a method of hiding your IP address. So if you do want to use torrents, if you do want to get files from torrents, that may be potentially questionable. If you do want to do that, then you need a method of hiding your IP address. And most simply, the easiest way to do that is just to use a VPN. So if there was someone that was trying to track, you know, which IPs are trying to download, you know, their content, because you're not using your real IP, it won't make a difference for you, because the IP address that they'll see in their logs, it won't belong to you. So nobody can know that it was actually you that was downloading that torrent. So I personally use IPVanish when I want to do anything online or download something, just to keep myself sort of anonymous and safe online. If you want to use the same VPN as me, I'll leave a link in the description. If you don't want to use a VPN, there are other methods out there. Like, for example, you could also use what's called a seed box. So a seed box is something that you basically pay for, and the seed box does the downloading for you. Then you yourself just access that content once it's already been downloaded. So if somebody was to see, if somebody was to go into that swarm and see which IPs are downloading this content, they'll only see the IP of the seed box, not your ISP. So you yourself are kept safe because it's the seed box that's actually doing the downloading for you. And once the seed box has the complete file, you can then just download that directly. So that's also another method if you don't want to use a VPN, but you still want to stay anonymous. Okay, so I think this is the one that everybody's been waiting for. So what actually does happen if you were to download something that is copyright? Now, let me just say it one more time, in a sense, like, you know, you can download copyrighted content, but if nobody cares, i.e. the copyright holder doesn't care, then it's not going to make a difference for you. You're not going to get any letter. Nobody's going to knock on your door. The police are not going to arrest you. Nothing like that. However, if you are a copyright holder and you want to make sure that, you know, your copyrighted, you know, movie or something else is not being illegally shared, then 100% you would, you know, join these torrent networks. You would get a list of all the IP addresses, and you would be sending letters via their ISP to tell that person they need to remove or stop sharing that copyrighted content. And that's exactly what happened to me. So for a test, I did download a movie. It was actually the Kong movie, and at that time I wasn't running a VPN. And basically I downloaded it, and then within a couple of days I received this email from my ISP. And let me just bring it up. And this is what it looks like. So you get an email from your ISP which says, you know, mine's from the abuse department, telling me that there's potential copyright infringement notification. It says to me that they received a takedown notice from an organization which believes that they're the rights holder, which is the copyright holder, for this content. This was the content here. They have alleged that a host on your network is being used for the distribution, download, or upload of the material without authorization, because obviously, so they are the copyright holder and somebody is, you know, illegally downloading or uploading this file. They have verified that they own this copyright. If we just look further down here, we can see it's actually Warner Bros. Entertainment. So it's their movie, they own the copyright, they don't want nobody downloading it or sharing it. And this is why they've now sent out this letter telling me I need to delete this content. So it was just a test, just to show you that if you were to download something, you know, that a copyright owner does care about, you can get these kind of letters. And here we can just see, because they had my IP address, it was very easy for them to find that it was me that was downloading it, because I wasn't using a VPN, I was using my normal IP. All they had to do was just join that swarm, find all the IP addresses that were downloading it, and just contact their ISP. So obviously if I was using a VPN, they wouldn't have been able to see my real IP there. Here we can just see that it was the BitTorrent protocol that was being used. This is the port that my client was using at the time, and here we can just see what the title was and what the movie was and how big it was. So it just shows you, like, you know, if you do want to go down this road and download, you know, potentially copyrighted material, it's very easy for them to find it if you do use your normal IP. Well, that's all for this video, guys. Many thanks for watching and many thanks for staying till the end. If you did find this video useful, then do give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more stuff like this, then definitely subscribe and hit the notification bell. As always, I always appreciate your likes, your shares, your comments, so do let me know what you think. Leave me a comment below, and I'll hopefully catch up with you guys real soon. Thanks.